Kenny Beats is a producer, audio engineer, and songwriter who over the years has become a household name within the music industry. He's made music with some of your favorite artists from the likes of Kendrick Lamar, Smino, Schoolboy Q, Vince Staples, and many more. He's known for his collaborative production style, unique instrumentation, and his Discord and Twitch communities have become one of the most popular in its space. So how exactly did Kenny Beats become your favorite producer? Kenny Charles Bloom III was born in Greenwich, Connecticut on May 10th, 1991. His music journey began at 9 years old when he started learning how to play the guitar. He began producing at the age of 17, and in high school, he would invite local rappers to his dad's apartment to record in a closet that he made into his own vocal booth. After high school, he got his first big opportunity by securing an internship with Cinematic Music Group in New York City. The label is owned and operated by Johnny Shipes, a New York City staple who has signed notable artists such as Joey Badass, Smoke Dizza, and Big Crit under his imprint. While interning there, he was able to secure his first major placements in 2010 with Smoke Dizza on the songs Head Stash and Continental Kush Breakfast.
I'm up. The headband's calling me. Handle things accordingly. Thank the Lord, grab my papers. Time for early session. Head stash the size of the pillow I rest my head on.
The following year in 2011, he would get to work with Dizza again, but this time with some major features on the record. He produced the songs Profit off of Dizza's project The Hustler's Catalog.
Money in the US dollars, they love a nigga in the T-Dot. Shit everywhere he rides.
As well as the songs Ball Game featuring TDE's Kendrick Lamar.
Ball game's done. In every inning, sure your career's ending. You niggas ain't winning, really, you're short-winded.
And Pow Wow featuring Dom Kennedy off of his project Rolling Stoned.
Dust at the head of the table.
Yeah, from where I'm sitting, I can't see y'all. I'm in this golf shirt about to pee off. This rap shit is like getting weed off. And I ain't buy these shades at no kiosk.
He described making a song with Kendrick at 19 years old as a major high point in his career, but this wouldn't be the last time Beats would get the chance to work with a TDE artist. As it turns out, in 2012, the producer started selling weed to TDE artists Schoolboy Q and Absol, and in return, they said they would listen to some of his beats. They would actually end up liking his production and decided to hop on three of them, with one of them being the track Party by Schoolboy Q. Fast forward to 2014, he would go on to do some more work with them when he produced the record Hunted Stacks featuring Schoolboy Q on Absol's album These Days.
You know I love cheeks. You know I love cheeks. I'm high as a scraper. I'm smoking that guac. Who leave guns on the top shelf? Who keep Glocks on Glocks?
So at this point, even though he was finding some success as a producer and working with some of his favorite artists, it wasn't very lucrative for him at the time, and he struggled to pay the bills. While going to school at Boston's Berklee College of Music, Kenny met Ryan Marks. Ryan had convinced him to make EDM music with him, which at the time was very popular in the college scene. In an interview with Pitchfork, Kenny said, "Someone at Berklee started showing me what was going on with electronic music, like Flostradamus and Bauer. I realized I made beats like this all the time and they didn't have any rappers over them." They formed the EDM duo Loud Pack during their senior year. The duo decided to hit the road and they found success. By 2017, the duo was touring the globe remixing songs by the Chainsmokers and hitting festival stages like Lollapalooza.
Get the fuck up. Simon says get the fuck up. Throw your hands in the sky. Ninjas in the back sipping yak, yo.
But after 3 years in the EDM world, Kenny found himself not fulfilled. He decided to get back to his first love, which was hip-hop. In an interview with GQ, he stated, "I think I hit a point at 25 years old where I was like, I'm fucked, it's over. I haven't made it yet. I haven't had any huge songs. I did one Kendrick beat when I was 19 years old, and that was my peak." Kenny decided to go all in on hip-hop at this point, and he got busy in the studio. He got the ball rolling in 2017 when he got the opportunity to work with rapper Hood Rich Pablo Juan on his mixtape South Dark. Pablo Juan insisted on making it a collaborative project with him, and Kenny sharing the cover. In an interview with GQ, Kenny stated, "Pablo really just said, I'm gonna put your name on the cover. I'm gonna wear the hoodie from South Park that Kenny wears on the cover. It's gonna be Pablo and Kenny," he recalls. This was a big deal and a trend for him going forward, as his team began noticing that collab projects were a much more effective way to get Kenny's name out there. Later that same year, he was also featured on Lil Wap's project Wapavelli 3. He ended up producing 6 tracks on that album. Fast forward to 2018, it became one of his busiest and most productive years yet. It started with him securing a placement on NBA YoungBoy's project Until Death Call My Name, where he produced track 9, Traumatized. He then put out another full collaborative project titled 777 with artist Key, and it didn't stop there, as he put out records with Freddie Gibbs, Zach Fox, Vince Staples, JPEG Mafia, 10K Cash, JID, and Ski Master Slump God. 2018 was sort of a breakout year for the 27-year-old producer, some would say. But his biggest moves really came in 2019. At this time, Kenny and his team had really pivoted toward developing his brand by creating various online communities and also creating more visual content. The timing couldn't have been more perfect, with the pandemic shutting down the world, causing more and more people to stay immersed online. It all began when in early March of that year, he started his new show called The Cave on his YouTube account, where he would record live sessions with artists he was working with. He would work with them to create a custom instrumental for them on the spot. Then the artist would go in the booth to record a freestyle to it afterward.
What are we doing today? What is your vibe? How are you feeling?
All right, so what's going to happen? I'm a fart, and then you sample that. And you make all the percussion, all the melodies, out of my fart into...
The live impromptu music, making a fun and loose vibe, made for an entertaining watch, and it immediately became a hit. It also introduced Kenny to a new audience. People would become fans, not necessarily because they listened to Vince Staples or Smino, but because they liked the show. You eventually see some of these songs made on the show be released and do pretty well, such as the record Jesus Is The One, I Got Depression with Zach Fox. Kid it, hey, little bitch, how you not gonna fuck on a real nigga? Yeah, I'm getting paid, still late on my bills, nigga. Yo, bitch at my crib, I just let her charge the iPhone. Ask me if these diamonds now, bitch, these some rhinestones. That same year, he created the Kenny Beats Twitch channel and Discord server, which would go on to become the second biggest Discord community for music on the platform. He really gives a lot of the credit for this to his manager and close friends, who collectively are all in business together under the name Dots, don't overthink-ish. The Twitch channel became almost a safe haven for a lot of people during the pandemic. At times, he would be showing thousands of people how to make music and giving out helpful tips and secrets regarding the trade. He began a series called The Pain Chat, where viewers could submit questions for him to answer about things they've been through.
Somebody else is getting sucked, bro, and you just gotta wait your turn. You can't be selfish.
There were beat battles where users were given a sample and a set amount of time to make a full beat, then voters would put it to a vote on who won.
My name is Kenny Beats. Today, we are having a beat live on Twitch. I'm giving away thousands of dollars worth of gifts. You have 1 hour to flip a sample. Would you like to know what that sample is?
Some even got publishing deals out of it from major record labels. His online community building became one of his biggest assets, as he started to get major bags from not even the music side, but by consulting for companies on the technology side of how to grow your brand online. In 2019, he continued staying active in the studio and released 2 new collaborative projects with Rico Nasty on Anger Management and O3 Greedo on Netflix and Deal. In 2020, he dropped another collab project with Denzel Curry titled Unlocked, then again with the band Trash Talk on the project Squalor. He secured a ton of placements that year in general, some of the more notable being Magic with Slow Tie, Florida with Dominic Fike, and Bugatti with Smino and JID. The following year, in 2021, he produced Vince Staples' entire album titled Vince Staples, and also released a sequel to Unlocked with Denzel Curry, Unlocked 1.5. Currently, Kenny is on a promotional run for his latest album, Louie, that was inspired in a tribute to his father, who was diagnosed with pancreatic cancer last year. The project consists of different voice recordings between he and his father, and the record actually opens up with a conversation between them discussing how Kenny was given the nickname Louie as a kid. We'll see how the next phase of Kenny's career will go, as the past 5 years have been fun to watch, but as for now, we can only wait and see.